guys, time for a model update, and it's my first video for 2017. I haven't done one for a couple of weeks. 2016 was a pretty good year for me, done a lot of good builds, from the little Sherman tank to X-Wings, Snowspeeders, the tricorder conversion as well. That was good. That's still up on the shelf, still looking good and still functioning, everything's still running, all the lights looking great on it. What else was there? The bladder cancer awareness build as well, done that. And yeah, I was 2016 was a pretty good year for model building, really, all in all. But I'm going to kick this one off. This one isn't going to be an update to the Galileo video, though I will be getting on with that, and I will be showing you that very, very soon, because there are some things that I've got recorded ready. But this one is going to be an unboxing video. And I don't normally do unboxing videos, but for this one I'm going to make an exception. Because it's a model that I've been wanting ever since I was a kid. And I've never got one, because either it was seemed too expensive, or it seemed like it was at the wrong size or scale, or the quality didn't seem right, or anything like that. So for one reason or another, I've just been putting it off. Well, Christmas came around and I had the opportunity to get a Christmas present for myself, and I did. And here it is. It is Thunderbird 2. Oh yes. Oh yes. So I'm going to switch the camera off now, and I'm going to bring you over to the table, and we're going to open this puppy up, and we're going to take a good look at the, I can't pronounce this, Aoshima Plastic Model Superbig Thunderbird 2. Moving on. So here it is, Thunderbird 2. Why have I always wanted Thunderbird 2? Well, in the early 90s, Thunderbirds went through a revival. And it just literally, it went skyrocketing. I mean, we're talking about a show. The show was being repeated, I think it was on a Thursday night, I think, and then it was shown again on a Sunday morning. And literally, during the early 90s, everybody was watching Thunderbirds. And it sparked a whole revival of the Gerry Anderson genre. It wasn't just Thunderbirds, they were showing Captain Scarlet, Stingray, all that sort of stuff. And it just went through a monster revival. I mean, it literally made huge celebrities out of people. Don't believe me, just ask Anthea Turner, okay? You can't say Anthea Turner without saying Tracy Island. So they started reissuing the toys for Thunderbirds, and they started doing new toys for Thunderbirds. A little, you know, things that were updated and a little more sophisticated than what they were on their original release. And if anybody remembers the frenzy that was caused by that, it was, you could not get Tracy Island. You just couldn't get it. And that's what led to Anthea Turner's fame, was because she ended up building it on Blue Peter and showing people how you could build your own Tracy Island. And it just skyrocketed from there. But I always loved Thunderbird 2, because Thunderbird 1 was always a pretty cool thing, but it was the one that just got to the scene, done the, assessed the danger. But it was Thunderbird 2 that would, like, you know, this is the thing, this is what we need this, 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 and this. And it would always tool up and fly out, and it was always sort of, it was just a bit of Thunderbird's magic, you know. You knew that you were on for the adventure when Thunderbird 2 landed. Or drop the pod off. So yeah, it was just like, you know, I like Thunderbird 4, the mole. Thunderbird 5 is a little bit meh, but Thunderbird 2 was the one that was just like, you know, now the adventure begins. So enough of that, let's open up this box and take a look and see what we got. And we got a pretty big size Thunderbird 2. Okay, that doesn't look right to me. That's the bottom of the pod. And if I remember Thunderbird 2 rightly, it had two sets of rolling wheels across the bottom, as opposed to this, which looks like it's prepped for four wheels. But that's not really a problem. I can plug those up. That's not an issue. It's a good size though. Look at the size of that pod. You know, that's it's pretty decent size. So that's that. We got the main upper body of Thunderbird 2, which that's a, you know, when it says super big, okay, it's not massively big. I tell you what, it's probably the same size as one of the studio models. Not the largest one that they had, but it's probably as large as the mid-size studio model. The windows need unblocking. Let me take it out of the bag. Let's do this tidy, shall we? Okay, things that I don't like. The 2 and the T2 are embossed, so I'm not keen on that. That's the same on the underside wing there. But again, that's nothing that can't be taken care of. Again, the windows are plugged up instead of being open for glass pieces. Not a huge issue there either, just do some drilling and some filing, basic stuff. The entry hatch looks okay. I don't know if that's a little bit deep. I'll check the studio model for that, but I don't know if that's a bit deep. It looks okay to me. So yeah, it's very clean, very slick. There's no panel lines on it whatsoever. There's a couple of molding indents here and there. But, you know, as a basis, yeah, it's looking pretty good. There's a little bit of flashing going on the side there. But yeah, that's that. There's the instructions, we'll get onto those. What's that? Oh, wait a sec. Let's do the bottom. Let's have a look at the bottom. Open this. Get that out. Oh, okay. That's a bit weird. I hadn't noticed that before. I wonder if they got glass pieces to go in there, because they are sort of just cut out indents. As opposed to windows, so I wonder if there's glass pieces to go in there. That's a bit unusual. I wasn't expecting that. Again, the 2 is embossed. That appears to be a screw hole. So I'm guessing that. Let me have a look here. Yeah, I think that is. Yeah, this is. This is made to be screwed together. Okay, well, that's not a problem. There's nothing wrong with that. A little bit of extra security. It seems to match up pretty well to the top side. There's nothing really wrong with that. There is a little bit of cleanup needed here and there, like you see. Seaming shouldn't be a problem. Given what I've done on Starbug, seaming on this is a piece of cake. So that's the top and bottom of it. Let's have a look, see what else we got in here. Plastic support pylons for the pods. It's doing halves for there. Open this up. The quality of the plastic, it does feel like a toy. I will say that. The quality of, oh, there's Thunderbird 4. Oh, okay. It's in there. Yeah, no, sorry. The quality of the plastic does feel like a toy. It really does. So yeah, it's not really a. It is a model kit, but it's not what you would sort of what you'd expect for a model kit. It's definitely aimed at a younger demographic. Yeah, it's odd that they molded these in red. It's a bit peculiar there. They come with the feet as well to go on the bottom, and I guess those are to plug into the model. And there seem to be some sort of caps for there as well. So there's that. Let's put that on there. T2 take a look inside. Oh, and the mole is in here as well. I didn't, you know, I've seen the box art on the front. It didn't twig that that's what was actually all in the box. And this Thunderbird one. Cool. Okay, well, okay, there's Thunderbird 4. Just sitting by there, and it appears to be all the parts for Thunderbird 4. That's very cool. Okay. Yeah, again, it because the way they've done the pod with the big wheels and everything, it occurred to me that it is much more of a toy than a model, and they've done the same sort of thing with Thunderbird 4. I couldn't work out what those were, but they just realised then they are holes for wheels. So, that's going to have to be filled. It would have been nice for them to... Have they? Let me just check. No. That's the only yellow sprue there. I was wondering if they'd actually given you the option of putting something in there to plug those up, but no. There's the mole as well, and the track that the mole sits on, and the wheels for the track as well. Have they given you tracks for it? They must have. Let's put that aside for now. Now, what is in here? I haven't got the foggiest idea. That appears to be gearing. Those appear to be missiles. In fact, they don't even appear to be missiles. They are missiles. Okay. Large wheels. Fairly large wheels. Don't know what that's for. Oh, it's going to be for one of the other ones. Okay, that's a bit unusual. What are these here? They appear to be feet. Or some sort of spacer. Ah, the decals as well. So, decals give you the yellow striping for Thunderbird 2. The decals for Thunderbird 5, which is there. The mole, Thunderbird 4. And a selection of numbers for the pods, so you can choose whatever pod you want. That's okay. It's all workable so far. There's nothing. I'm not disappointed by any stretch of the imagination. Let's drop those out of the bag. So look what's in here. What the hell's... Okay, I'll get on to that. Let's take a look at these first. So, this Thunderbird 1... Doesn't exactly look right to me, Thunderbird 1. There's something... I don't think that cone shape is right at the top. I could be wrong, but... I always thought the cone was a bit more concaved and separate from the rest of the body. Again, they've put these slots in to put wheels on it by the looks of it. It's a shame, but there we are. And obviously down here we've got Thunderbird 5, which again has wheels. It's a space station. Come on. What are you doing putting wheels on a space station? I think these... What are they? Are they meant to be like smoke trails or something? Possibly. But yeah, so give Thunderbird 5 as well. And Thunderbird 1 and use the little fins and everything. Molding quality... Again, the molding quality is much like a toy. It's not like what you'd expect from something like Bandai or something like that. It's far more simplistic. But it does give you... It does give you the basics for a model kit. Sort of cool going in your back here. Oh, that's the rear tail end of Thunderbird 2. This huge harmonica. So there's that. That appears to be... These are the big fins at the back that support this. That is broken. But that's fixable, so that's okay. There's nothing wrong with that. I can sort that out. These These are wrong. These are very, very wrong. They've got these cutouts in them, and why just take a look at the instructions. What have we got here? Oh, okay, alright, okay. So, that's why they're wrong. They need to be replaced. They are wrong because apparently it fires missiles. So those large missiles that were on the other sprue, it fires them out of here by the looks of it. There's the front door for Thunderbird 4, or for the pod. Again, it's not what I was expecting. But overall, if you're just going to build Thunderbird 2 and not worry about the others really, it gives you everything here that you need. You've got the rear engine boosters. It's Thunderbird 2. There's a little bit of a nasty, where they've put a solid block of plastic through there, there's a nasty dip in the plastic there which can be filled, sanded and filled. But all the components look right, aside from the front grills there where they've decided to toy it up a little bit, and the other side of the pod which got those massive holes in it. That's why I couldn't work out what these, there's a lot of screws and springs in here. I couldn't work out what they were for. And obviously it's for you to build the firing mechanism for, there's axles in there for the wheels, there's springs and screws to put it together, and obviously the tyres for the pod, for the Thunderbird 2's pod. So that's that. What are they? One sec, I got a little open. Where has my scissors? Ooh! These are supports for. They give you the plastic, red plastic ones, and they give you these metal ones. And they retract! Oh, that's quite nice. The fact that they give you the telescopic legs, that's pretty nice. They're a bit firm, but yeah, I mean, if you think about it, they need to be quite firm if they're going to hold up the model for Thunderbird 2 to sort of stand above the pod. Isn't that odd? They give you the plastic ones and these metal ones. But they are funky. Very, very nice. Very, very nice. So let's have a look at the instructions. Let's see what the instructions have to say. Let's take a look here. They seem to be in Japanese and English. So they give you the layout of Thunderbird 2 with all the decal placements from all sides, and the pod separate as well. Thunderbird 4. It's just a very basic exploded view of Thunderbird 4. It's like this one picture tells you how to put everything together, and the decals and the paint. Same really, there's only these two pictures for Thunderbird 1, which is very basic. Again, it doesn't really look like Thunderbird 1 because of that nose section. Same with the mole. The mole is basically, well, 8 pieces. Thunderbird 5 is just 2 pieces.
Yeah, it's got the mech. Oh, the spring goes in inside the missile. So you put it in. Oh, that's a bit. Okay. Okay, yeah, so that loads onto a pin and then you fire it off. Right, okay, makes sense. But yeah, looking at the basics for Thunderbird 2. We got the, it's telling us to build, let me get this box out of the way. So it tells us to build the rear back cluster first, the wheel sections for the pod, again, I won't be doing that, there's no way in hell will I be doing that. They got some sort of release mechanism here as well. That's to release. Okay. Okay. There's a built-in release mechanism in the bottom of the pod, which looks like it clicks into. Does it click into the side of Thunderbird 2? I think it does. You know, I think that there's an armature inside that you press to release the pod from the model, but. I don't see anything on the model that I can click into. Okay, that's got me curious. Because I can't see absolutely, it's smooth. I can't see how that pod is just going to sit in there without falling out. Cannon. So, yeah, you build the top half, build the bottom half separately. Ah, those other plugs. But for on the underside for the VTOL rockets, okay. That looks pretty good. Yeah, I'm really confused as to how that's supposed to be held in place. I can't see anything that says that pod will hold itself in place. Yeah, now, here's an interesting thing. It says here not to use CA on these parts, but to use epoxy resin adhesives. They're on flexible legs. That's for the red plastic ones. But, yeah, I mean, overall, you end up with Thunderbird 1, Thunderbird 2, Thunderbird 4, 5, and the Maul. Why they give you the Maul and not Thunderbird 3, I don't know. I mean, I can understand why they give you the Maul, because it's a classic Thunderbird model, but given that they give you 1, 2, 4, 5, it's a bit odd that they give you 1, 2, 4, 5 and not 3. And like, you know, obviously they're not in scale. There's no correlation of scale between them. But, you know, for what I've got, for what I wanted, you know, As a bare basic model, as a sort of an entry level model, I suppose, it's not bad. I can do a lot with it. There's a lot, you know. They give you the bare bones, and you can do whatever you like with it. And that's what I'm gonna do. I think what I'm gonna do with the model, actually, I know a lot of people like to build Thunderbird 2 and have it with the pod. Dropped out with the legs extended. I don't think I'm going to do that. I think I'll cut out the windows and put those right and maybe build a cockpit for the inside. I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to take a little bit of a different approach to it. And I think I'm going to look up some images of Boeing 747s, and I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to paint it in the traditional green, but do it and treat it like a 747. So it's going to need sort of anti-collision lights and things like that. So I might have to route through there to put wingtip lights on, the anti-collision lights on, avoidance lighting on the top. Maybe put one on the top and on the pod as well, so that you've got one there, one there. Maybe on the rear as well, where these fins extend up, so you have one on either side. You're definitely probably going to need one on the underside of the pod, and obviously on the underside of Thunderbird 2 as well. Where you could put it, maybe there, just in between the VTOLs. And again, there's a massive amount of space in there as well, so it's, you know, lighting things like the rear engine boosters and things like that is going to be a piece of cake. There is a massive amount of space, so yes, it's a future project build, but I am looking forward to it. That is a very nice size. Overall, the quality could be better, but given that it is an entry-level model, clearly, and it's meant to be screwed together, so it's a bit more of a toy than it is a model. It's already molded in the green plastic, so, you know, that you can see. Those got to be sanded off, the 2s and the T2s got to be sanded off. And it needs a proper paint job. But again, there's really... For this sort of entry level model, there's really very little wrong with it. You know, I'm gonna have to have a good look at the studio miniature, but I think that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna build it with the pod in place, and I'm gonna treat it like it is an aircraft. I'm gonna give it a proper aircraft treatment. So that's that. So the Thunderbird 2, the quality of the molding is a little bit off-putting, but for Thunderbird 2 itself, there's nothing that's not fixable. It's all well doable. There's stacks of space inside the thing. I mean, absolutely stacks. It is a very well put together kit for what it is, given that it is an entry-level model. You know, it's not... I would put it at a level 1 to level 2 model, I would say. Well, level 2, because you've got to build the wheels and the gear in and stuff like that. So, but it's nothing more than that. The moulding on the smaller models, such as Thunderbird 4 and the Mole, are not good. Because, again, it's been very toy-like. It's been built so that these things are flexible and they're not going to bend or break. It's a bit confusing that they put wheels on things that shouldn't have wheels. You know, Thunderbird 5, it's got wheels for Thunderbird 5, what the hell? Thunderbird 4, I can understand. Thunderbird 4, there's something, you know... It's not quite right, but I can certainly understand why you would put wheels on Thunderbird 4. But it's good that they give you the mole. You know, it's not a great model. It's not fantastically molded. It's not, you know, crisp, sharp detail, and you've got these extruded panel lines over it instead of recessed grooves and things like that. There's details that are missing. It's very, very basic. And Thunderbird 1 is not right at all. I can't see the top end of Thunderbird 1. To me, it looks like the top needs to be cut off and a new top needs to be put on. But I won't be doing that. It is what it is. I only bought the kit for Thunderbird 2. I really wasn't expecting to have that much stuff with it. So, yeah, that's going to be my focus, is just Thunderbird 2. So what I do with Thunderbird 4, the mole and all that, that's something for another time. I'm not even concerned about that. So yeah, at some point over the next, after I've done the Galileo, I've got a couple of things that I really want to do, but Thunderbird 2 it's high on that list. It's right up there. Anyway, that's going to do for me. If you enjoyed this video,
feel free to, I can't colour a model update, I can't, can I? You just can't, it was an unboxing, I can't colour a model update. So if you've enjoyed this video, feel free to like, comment on this video, subscribe to the channel, or go over and join me on Google+. But until next time, I'll see you later, guys.